Hello friends, so today we are starting with a new module of simple techniques for building load calculations. So sorry, the marker is not working as expected. Simple techniques for building load calculations. Let's understand each of the terms which I am using right now, so it becomes very clear what we are going to cover in this module. So first, these are the simple techniques. What the simple techniques I am referring to right now are the historical methods. So simple techniques mean historical methods. And so why is this development of simple techniques necessary? It obviously took place in the starts of 20th century, around 1910-1920, when people started realizing that there's a requirement to start heating homes in a better manner, and we should be able to predict how much of these loads are going to come up in which duration or which location of the year or of the world's part. So not all part of the world required heating or cooling in 19th century. It's because after these 100 years we have a lot of issues going around, and the weather is not so comfortable that we need either heating or cooling or both, depending on the location and the duration of the year. But in, let's say, example, in Russia or in USA, Canada, and in such northern hemispheres, there's a lot of requirement of heating homes, and earlier there were use of coal and the petroleum things to heat up the homes. But later they started to use, more specifically still they would be using coal, but they also started to use gas. And to match the supply and demand, their aim now was to understand how the demand changes. So now they started to make some models out of it, and which could be used to predict how much coal could be used in which time, or what, and depending on what temperature outside. If it is so cold, if it is 35 degree Fahrenheit, how much coal would be used, or how much gas would be used. If it is going to be 45, how much gas and coal should be used, or how much demand would be there, so they can make the arrangements for supply. So these are not, these methods are not used today, but these are important because it has a lot of disadvantages. That's why they are not used, and they are builded up upon this. We have modern theories which are better versions of these methods, and we'll discuss about each of the disadvantages of whatever methods we have over here in the upcoming videos. But these are only, most of these were based on calculations for heating demand. Cooling demand was not at all realized on those times, but it was first done to estimate the natural gas sale. And the very basic simple model which they used looks like this. So their model was so simple. What they predicted was, this was the y-axis which says natural gas sales. I hope it is visible clearly. And this was the average temperature of the days. So how they calculated the average temperature is very simple. T average was T max plus T mean of the days divided by 2. Now it was that time when the temperature recordings were not as much available. Now obviously we have much more data available, where we have more accurate hourly basis of each temperature, so average temperatures in each hour of the day, and we can make a better estimate of that average temperature. But on those times we only have limited access of the data, so they use this this way to make the average temperature, but this was the average temperature axis. And their model was that very simple. This was a 65 degree Fahrenheit. So 65 degree Fahrenheit was an estimated or slightly calculated number. That's the outside temperature at which we'll have these two lines meeting each other, and that's called the balance temperature. So the concept of balance temperature is very simple. I'll just explain you the, in the words of it, the technical thing will be covered in upcoming videos. So in words, it means the situation when no heating or cooling is required. All the heat gains in the building are exactly equal to the heat loss from the building. So in net, in total, we do not need to heat or cool our buildings, right? All the heat gain is equal to the heat loss. That's the balance temperature. So at 65 degree Fahrenheit, they assume that there is a balance temperature. We do not need to heat or cool our homes. This is the a constant temperature. That's because to take care into account the domestic water heating. That's the water heating required for domestic water use. While this increase in the slope, when we go to a lower temperature, this is a lower temperature. This could be some 45 degrees Fahrenheit, and this could be 80 degree Fahrenheit. So anything outside temperature above 65 degrees Fahrenheit, we do not need to heat our homes. That was the assumed temperature, balance temperature. So if we have any temperature above 65, we'll not heat the home. We'll just heat the water which we use to bath or cook food or anything. While for any temperature which is below 65, we start on heating our homes to make it more comfortable. And hence, the natural gas, extra natural gas or coal is to be used, which will increase the amount of demand. And that's the amount of sales also. So that's the model they had. And the amount of sale is simply given by Q, which is equal to some factor K into 65 minus T average, right? T average positive. What does that mean is, this term means, that term means that 65 minus T average is equal to, we'll take the positive values, that's the basic meaning, T average minus A and 0 if T average is less than 65 and if T average is greater than equal to 65 degree Fahrenheit, obviously. That's understood. So that's the basic understanding, and K is some factor. So the amount of sales is determined by this very simple formula. And based on this analogy, they have defined four other methods to do the building load calculations. And these four methods will be discussed individually in the upcoming four videos. So one of the method is So the first method is degree day method. The second one is modified degree day method. The third is variable base degree day method. And the fourth one and the last one which we'll be covering is equivalent number full load hours. None of these methods are used right now in industry. Those are very obsolete. None of them are used. But the advantages of this method, so this degree day method has the highest number of disadvantages. So to improve among some of the disadvantages are taken care of and the